Okay, let's clear up a little confusion about onsets and time stretching and stuff like that. All right. So in Bitwig, they call them onsets, but in other audio editing programs, they might be called warp markers. It could be elastic audio and like in Pro Tools. But basically, onsets are these lines, these vertical lines, and their purpose is to kind of signify an anchor point on the audio waveform that you see behind it. So, and what that does is make it so that when you go over to stretch, it creates a point there that is anchored to the audio that I can then go and move it. If it's off the grid, I can put it onto the grid, okay? Now, in general, you're gonna wanna avoid having onsets that are placed like this. See, there's no real transient there. This is not a drum hit that's happening. For whatever reason, the Bitwig algorithm has just decided to put one there, and if you wanna get rid of it, you simply double click on it. If you need to move one, say for example, you don't want this there, but rather you want it here, I don't know why you would, but you can just grab it and slide it over, okay? You can hold shift, and that makes it so you can put it in between the grid. Otherwise, it'll kind of click to where it wants to go. Okay? And like I said, that's just creating anchor points in the audio waveform for which you will then use to stretch. So go over to stretch now, over here. And now I've created an anchor. And if I hold Alt or Option, I can stretch it like that. It effectively changes timing. So it's nothing, not a big deal. It's good, it's basically you're quantizing recorded audio. And there's a super handy feature to have. As far as I'm concerned, every DAW should have something like this. And actually, Bitwig's algorithm for stretching is really clean. If you ever take a clip like this, put it in a stretch HD mode, and then just stretch it out like crazy, make it like 10 times longer, and then do that in a bunch of other audio programs like Pro Tools, especially Ableton, whatever else you have, Cubase. This one sounds almost as good as Pro Tools does. It's just that Pro Tools makes it a pain for you to use it, and this is very easy to do. So that's it. Just a quick blurb on onsets and stretch. All right, folks, don't forget to subscribe. Leave me any comments or questions. You can email me directly, and I'd be happy to answer anything that you're wondering about. Okay? Alrighty. Take care.